Invisibility cloaks sound like science fiction, but in our lab, the science behind them is real.
I'm David R. Smith, and I study metamaterials. When it started out, a lot of people said, why would you study that? And here I think we have an answer. Metamaterials have properties that go beyond what you can get in nature. When you think of how you see things, light at something like glass or plastic, will bend slightly inwards when it enters the medium, and that's called refraction. One of the things that we discovered with metamaterials is that we could bend the wrong way entirely. But that was the first time anyone had seen a negative index of refraction, and that really kicked off the field of metamaterials. Our collaborator, Sir John Pendry, said, you know, a simple thing we could do would be an invisibility cloak, and he proposed it as a joke, actually. And we were like, no, we could actually do that, at least as a science experiment. So what this structure did was to take a wave, and it would break the wave up and route it around the circle and then restore it on the other side. So it looked as if it had just passed through space. And in here, you could actually hide things commercially. Really, you typically don't want to make things invisible. It's often that you want to see the invisible. We've done research to use the waves, you know, mediated by metamaterials, to see through things. One of those projects was to develop a security scanner for DHS and TSA. More recently, we've taken that same technology to look behind walls to see what's behind there. The work on metamaterials all emerged from fundamental research. At the time, we had no idea what it would be good for in a practical sense. Federal funding was really important to get us to that point and really provide that breakthrough. We've now spun off about a dozen companies and are still going, and these companies have investment of over $1 billion. What started as a fun idea kicking around the lab is now actually creating industries, and that's really exciting. If you're curious how research like this can change lives, like and subscribe to us.